Are you wondering if civil engineering has a good future, if it is a good situation for you leading forward? Well, in this video, we're going to talk about three key reasons why I believe it is the case coming up right now. Hey, 1% Nation, I'm Jake Voorhees, and you are watching episode 42 of the 1% Engineer Show, where we empower young engineers to rise to the top 1% of their career. And if you're a young engineer, make sure you subscribe because I release videos 3 times per week on engineering success. And if you have a specific question about succeeding in engineering, comment below, and I can make you a video just on that. So as all of you know, I myself am a civil engineer, and I'm going to weigh in on this topic. And a lot of this video has to do with what just happened in the United States last weekend. Hurricane Harvey smashed into the Houston metropolitan area, creating ridiculous amounts of damage and affecting literally millions of people. And that is reason number one why I believe civil engineering has a good future. Natural disasters will always plague our major cities, no matter where we are in the world, and we will have to repair and maintain our infrastructure forever, even if we see no more population growth and no more advanced technologies into infrastructure and buildings and bridges and dams and everything like this. We will still need to repair, we will still need to maintain, and we cannot control what happens via hurricanes and mudslides and tornadoes and forest fires. They will always, always destroy the stuff we have built because Mother Nature is a ridiculous force of energy and there is no way to avoid it. And I do want to talk a lot about Harvey and the engineering ramifications that a storm, that an event like this has on our country, on our cities like Houston. Most of the Houston area received over 40 inches of rain, and in some accumulation areas, 52 inches of rainfall. We're talking about the greatest storm that Texas has ever seen. And Harvey has set records for the most precipitation a cyclone has ever dumped on the contiguous United States. Ever, 17,000 rescues were made, over 30,000 people were displaced from their homes, and over 60 people have died so far. It is a tragic, tragic, very, very sorry event. I cannot believe what has happened there in Houston. So my prayers go out to all the families, all of the people who have been affected by this. I do know some engineers who are actually living in Houston right there. My buddy Matt Schmidt is safe and well, so I'm so, so happy. I've been thinking of him this entire time. And hats off to all of you 1% engineers down there in Texas, Brianne, Martin, and Fernando Ceballos. You guys are down there. You're not in the Houston area, but you are in Texas. And I know you're doing everything you can to raise funds and support the area. So thank you guys for that. But the reason why this is very significant for this video is that it is not just Houston that is seeing crazy flooding right now or the rest of the summer here in 2017. Bangladesh and India, the death count is now up to 1,200 people due to flooding this year. Nigeria has seen a displacement of about 100,000 people. Nepal has had 80,000 homes damaged and around 140 deaths. Sierra Leone has seen mudslides that have killed over 500 people this summer. So it's not just Texas, guys. All around the world, we are seeing insane natural disasters. I'm not going to start talking about global warming. I'm not going to start talking about designs to prevent these. What I do want to talk about is the fact that civil engineers and engineers in general are required to repair and maintain this infrastructure. So I really do believe that me as a civil engineer, job security is strong because of this. We're always going to have to clean up what Mother Nature has done. We're always going to have to fix the things. So this alone, natural disasters, is a massive, massive reason why we're always going to need people like me around, people like civil engineers, all of you 1% civil engineers. So I believe that the industry is strong. So that's the main purpose for this video, to talk about Harvey and to talk about, yes, in this huge tragedy, we do see death, and I am very sorry to witness this, but engineers have to go and clean up the rubble and fix things and get society back to normal and fix these roads. And with the support of FEMA, save as many people's homes as we possibly can, continue to save as many people's lives as we possibly can, but we have to clean up, dust ourselves off, and rebuild. And that's where the engineers come in. We will see a huge amount of project spikes and infrastructure development in that area. So we just need to get back to work. The second reason why civil engineering has a strong future is that we see about 80 million new people on this planet each year. We're growing at about 1.1% population growth per year on the planet. It was peaking in about 1960s. We're talking post-World War II era when things were positive in the world and money was flowing very freely. But still, we're adding 80 million people per year. So more buildings, more roads, more cars, more jobs, more everything has to occur. So we will continually have to build, and this means more projects for civil engineers, which is job security, guys. And reason number three why civil engineering has a good future is that we're always coming out with new technologies, new procedures, new ways of producing steel and concrete blocks, and now we're 3D printing buildings and things like this. So we are constantly in this perpetual cycle of things falling into obsolescence, things becoming older, and we need to use new techniques, we need to use new technologies, we need to deploy new ways of creating bridges and creating buildings. So we're constantly in a situation where we need to sweep away old techniques and gradually build better buildings, better bridges, better infrastructure in general. So not only do we have population growth, not only do we have crazy natural disasters that destroy things and we have to rebuild, but we're always looking for opportunities to build things better than before so that it will be stronger, safer, last longer, and everything like this, guys. So those are the top three reasons why civil engineering has a good future. If you're a civil engineer or if you're an engineer in general, comment below and let me know what you think about this video, what you agree with, what you disagree with. And if you like this video, guys, if you're a young engineer, make sure you subscribe because I release videos 3 times per week for engineering student success. Thanks for watching the 1% Engineer Show, guys, and stay hungry on your quest to become a 1% engineer. Cheers.